Breaking: Judge slaps down lawsuit against Trump financed by mysterious donor. This could go deep. Leadership over the Consumer Financial Protection Bureau is now in confusion, as both the president's chosen candidate and the person selected by the former director showed up for the job. It's now resulted in a fierce legal battle. Leandra English, who was named the effective new director by Richard Cordray when he stepped down Friday, is filing a lawsuit seeking to stop the appointment of Mick Mulvaney, who was Trump's choice, Reuters reports. U.S. District Judge Timothy Kelly has refused to issue a temporary restraining order, DRO, preventing President Trump from naming Mick Mulvaney as acting director of the CFPB, Consumer Financial Protection Bureau. He has not ruled on the merits of the case, but if he was leaning towards Leandra English, he would have issued the TRO. Kelly's actions means that Mulvaney is the sole administrator of the CFPB. There is a bit of mystery surrounding English's lawsuit against Trump. Who is paying for the services of Deepak Gupta, the lead lawyer of a boutique law firm? He isn't cheap. Gupta confirmed that English isn't paying him and that a secret donor is paying for the lawsuit. Gupta, however, refuses to name the secret benefactor. Knowing the donor's identity could be of extreme importance. If it is someone regulated by the CFPB currying favor, that would be a crime. The CFPB is in reality a slush fund for the Democrats. They set up the CFPB to be totally unregulated by Congress, the president, or the courts. The director has the sole ability to make charges against companies that are not allowed to offer a defense and have no way to appeal the director's decision. Furthermore, the director decided the size of the fines and the money. The CFPB also has no accountability in how they spend their money. The truth is that leftist groups and not the alleged victims of the financial institutions get the vast bulk of the money. That brings up another reason why the mysterious donor's identity is important. The donor could be tied to one of the leftist groups that get loads of money from the CFPB, such as Planned Parenthood, which it would be equally illegal. From the Daily Caller. Gupta refused to name who is funding the lawsuit, making it difficult to ascertain the motives, intentions, or any special interests of those underwriting the case. The D.C. lawyer appeared caught off guard when CNBC hosts asked who was financing his effort. He stumbled over his words in his first answer and said some form of unidentified structure was being put in place to accept funds from anonymous donors. Well, Miss English. There are ethics lawyers that we've consulted, and we have a structure set up that is with ethics rules and, we'll be talking about that once we have that, he told CNBC. English says that she will appeal Judge Kelly's decision, but she can't. TROs can't be appealed. She will have to wait for Kelly to rule on the merits of the case, and if he rules against her, she can then appeal to the D.C. Circuit Court. Of course, she will have to convince them to ignore Article 2, Section 2 of the Constitution. He shall have power, by and with the advice and consent of the Senate, to make treaties, provided two-thirds of the senators present concur, and he shall nominate, and by and with the advice and consent of the Senate, shall appoint ambassadors, other public ministers and consuls, judges of the Supreme Court, and all other officers of the United States, whose appointments are not herein otherwise provided for, and which shall be established by law, but the Congress may by law vest the appointment of such inferior officers, as they think proper, in the President alone, in the courts of law, or in the heads of departments. The President shall have power to fill up all vacancies that may happen during the recess of the Senate, by granting commissions which shall expire at the end of their next session. The legislation creating the CFPB came from Congress, who wields no power over the executive branch, which is controlled solely by the president. It will be interesting to see who the donor turns out to be. If it's a left-wing overlord, which it's looking more likely to be, we're going to have one heck of a scandal on our hands. This could be a massive attempt by liberal billionaires to yet again protect their secrets and undermine the Trump presidency.